WMC world champion at 160 pounds, world title, and the contender Asia title in the Spirit Arena in 2008. Undefeated in his last 31. Samy Sana needs to use the reach, needs to use the knees. Cannot allow Yod on the inside because Yodsanklai's left hand and Yodsanklai's left roundhouse kicks are straight from the depths of hell.
I like how he opened up with that left high kick, or right high kick rather, and he just keeps that left hand nice and tight to Yod's face. Also keeps him at range. He's got to keep him at distance. Utilize that long reach advantage that he's got. He's got almost 19 centimeters in height advantage. He's got to use it.
Yodsanklai taking his time, seeing what Sana has to offer, trying to find a way to get inside the long arms, the long legs of the towering Frenchman. Nice check there from Sana. Yodsanklai doubles up to the lead leg. And there's the first real taste of the left hand of God. Fans have tipped Yodsanklai and Petrosian to make it through the final of this historic Featherweight Grand Prix tournament. But Samy Sana says he has the keys to unlock Yodsanklai tonight and take Yod out of the bracket.
Wants to use that right kick a lot, and he's doing it already. He's just got to go to the body, go to the inside of the leg, and go up top. Just over and over. You know, it's kind of impressive that, like, Yodsanklai's first match in Muay Thai was for 63 cents, which was 20 baht, and now he's two matches away from $1 million.
Yodsanklai, nice high guard there from Yod, just defending, goes to the back leg of Samy Sana, trying to connect with the right hand, that being the jab of the southpaw Thai. Sana thrusts out the jab, inside leg kick from the Frenchman. High guard on Sana as well, it should be. Backs up Yodsanklai, a good roundhouse kick off the back leg, turning left hook from Sana, who will advance to face Jabir Askarov in the semi-final round. High kick again from Sana, looking for the headache maker. Yod probing with the jab, setting the left hand.
Nice jab by Yodsanklai.
Yodsanklai competed against the great Wayne Parr three times, and Parr said that every time he competed against Yod, well, he aged 10 years.
He's just watching.
Nice head evasion. Body shot from Yodsanklai. Sana tries to back him up with a knee. There's a left hook from Sana. Yod goes to the bread basket again. Got to get off the ropes here, Yod, and he does. Roundhouse kick from Yodsanklai. Sana with the uppercut. Yodsanklai tries to power through the double forearms guard. We've been used to seeing Yodsanklai so far in one super series in the 4 ounce class.
Wow, I'm a little bit in shock like that. Look at this, Samy Sana. Oh, look at that. It was the kicks. That's what happened. He caught him right on the chin with that beautiful red high kick. And you can see he never quite got over it. And then Sana lands that big hook. Samy Sana just got a 10-8, Michael Schiavello. How do you feel about that?
Clean knockdown for Samy Sana. It was a beauty. Have a look at this. Lands that right hand perfectly. Backs up Yodsanklai here. Yodsanklai wide open. And it was just timing from Samy Sana. I don't believe Yodsanklai's heard from it, but it was a knockdown nonetheless. Samy Sana will be oozing out of every pore with confidence now. And Yodsanklai needs to reset and reset in a hurry.
How can he not be hurt from it? He fell twice. He got up and then he fell back down. It has to be hurt.
No. Yeah, I don't believe he's hurt. I don't believe there's any lasting damage from that, Mitch. I believe Yod got up from it, no problem. But it's a knockdown. It scores well for Samy Sana. But Yod's okay. Let's see how he recovers here.
Like, well, you're seeing something that Mitch and I are not. We clearly saw a knockdown that hurt.
Roundhouse kicks now from Yod. We'll see him turn up the artillery now, turn up the mercury, especially off that back leg, and he cracks away to the ribs of Samy Sana. Jab from Yod.
I didn't believe it when Samy Sana said he was going to stand there and trade with Yod, and he was doing just that. He's taking zero space as he let the combinations go. Yod's got to move.
Yodsanklai getting covered here by Samy Sana on the inside, and now Yod rallies back. But Samy Sana hit him with the uppercut.
Go to war. It's what he wanted.
They're going at it. They're going at it like the mountain and the hill. Sankai's chance. The high knee again from Sana.
That's two GOAT references.
Sana wants to stay in a phone booth with Yodsanklai Fairtex, and Yod is happy to stand there. They are juking it out toe to toe. This is insanity.
Somebody's gonna fall. These guys are letting it all go.
Yodsanklai jab then goes to the body.
Stop!
Looks like Dump here does. Semi Sana and referee Dilepsis says, no, no, no. This isn't Muay Thai.
Good balance shown by Yod there. He's able to stay up on his feet.
No catching either. A warning there again from Elias Dilepsis. Good refereeing from him. Yodsanklai goes to the body. Sana throws the uppercut. Yodsanklai. It's been a while since he's been in the bigger gloves. As I said, previously in one Super Series, it's all been four-ounce gloves, and he's been decimating opponents. He's trying to knock out Samy Sana now. Sana comes to play. Here they go, toe-to-toe. Amazing scene, Tia Misha. You've got to be loving this.
Wow, I'm just on the edge of my seat. I just know one of them is about to go down. I will say that Yodsanklai has got to be careful about dropping that backhand, because when you have the tall fighter, Samy Sana, he's bringing up that knee and that kick. One of those can really be deadly.
Who will advance to the semi-final round to take on Jabir Askarov? Who will move a closer step to US $1 million? Oh, Samy Sana looks the head back. And Yod makes sure his mouth guard's still intact. Mitch, this is just ferocious. This is phenomenal. This is one Super Series kickboxing.
I like how Yod's using that uppercut inside, but he's got to be careful, because as he's bringing his hands up, he's letting his hands drop. He's so comfortable, and he relies on his power so much. Big right hand landed by Sana.
Samy Sana lands the right hand to Yodsanklai. There's a left hook from Yod in the uppercut. Sana's got to go. Singapore. This is a stash. This is a battle. This is what it's all about. It's pure theater. It's pure buff offense. It's one Super Series match, and it's awesome.
Look at Sana just putting in work. Beautifully timed shot. Look at that. Good covers up. Big gloves are going to help that. Sana says, all right, my turn. You go, I go. You go, I go. And Sana just put together a five-piece combination right there and adds two more with an extra drink. But then Yod says, all right, my turn. You got me. I'm going to get you. That uppercut, that's doing the dirty work. Look at that. He goes back to it. Oh, you're starting to see the eyes wobble back. But Sana was able to regain it and go right back in. You can't clinch, though.
Okay, Misha, unofficially, that second round, unofficially, who do you give it to?
Oh, to score that one, I think I was too enthralled with it. I don't even know. That was just an epic round. I don't care who won that round, to be honest. I'm the winner of that round, just getting to watch it.
That's the perfect word, sold out. Not one empty seat inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium.
Ready?
This has been an amazing third and final round. A shot down on Yodsanklai in the third. Yod rallied back in the second. Looked like he may have come close to dropping Sana, but it didn't happen for the tie. And here they go toe-to-toe again. You get flashes of 2001 in Fukuoka, Mark Hunt versus Ray Seppo in an all-time K-1 classic. We're seeing the makings of an all-time one Super Series classic. Body shot from Yodsanklai, step up knee from Samy Sana. Yod tries to force him back with the hands.
You can see Sana's trying to. Oh, he caught him with a big right hand off the kick.
Now Yodsanklai feels it. Now Yodsanklai's home. Here comes Samy Sana. Samy Sana can sniff it. He can sense it. He can smell it. Yodsanklai might be right for the picking. And referee Dilepsis cautioning Samy Sana.
Can't clinch. That's what he's warning him of. You can see Sana was trying to get in there, but he was just letting those close range strikes go.
Yod goes to the body. He's taking far too much head punishment, though, Yodsanklai. He's got to be smart now. He's got to understand why they call in the boxing computer. You've got to think about it, Yod. You can't stand in that phone booth and let Samy Sana rain up punches on you. Body shot from Yod. Knee there from Samy Sana. A tremendous battle of attrition. This is when you've got to dig deep. This is when it's more than kicks, more than punches. It's guts. It's intestinal fortitude. It's that Bushido spirit, Mitch.
Man, they are just trained. You can see the huge spot. There's just a bunch of
flying.
I had to pause because I saw it.
How taste my feet?
Oh, my God. Just eating these shots, Michael.
And Yodsanklai rallies back. Samy Sana has hit him with some absolute anvils. The uppercut from Samy Sana.
This could be a giant upset by a lot if Samy Sana is able to pour it on here the last 60 seconds of the match.
Sana said he could do it. He said he had the keys to unlock the riddle of Yodsanklai. Rocks the head back again.
Stop! Right.
And there's no defense. They're just catching all the punches with their face.
Yodsanklai goes to the jaw of Sana. A right hand from Sana. A step through knee again. Sana comes forward, locks up Yod, and Prix de Lapsus breaks him. 45 seconds remains. Throws the knee again. Yod's got to go to work now. He's got to put the foot down, pull out all the stops, caution to the wind. It's time for Yod to go. But has he got it in the tank, the veteran?
30 seconds left in the final round.
That second round was ultra close.
Yodsanklai, so many people's overwhelming favorite removed from this tournament. Are we going to see him eliminated at the hand, the knee, the kicks of Samy Sana? The right hand again from Sana. Yodsanklai trying to get through, trying for the knockout punch, the knockout roundhouse kick, but it's not coming for him. And there it is. There it is. He will advance to the semi-final round.
See one Super Series athlete, Benny's not to it, celebrating in the corner like his boy came away with the victory, and Sana jumps up into the corner. We gotta see some highlights of that round because it was filled with them over and over, just going toe to toe. You could have tied these two together because there was no movement, just standing in front of him. Look at that, sucking on the heel of the foot there from Samy Sana. But then Sana still comes back. Look how he takes it on the arm, tries to parry it away, and then just comes straight down the middle with a huge right hand from Samy Sana.
Misha, we are absolutely breathless and speechless after that. It was incredible.
Incredible is exactly what I was thinking. A really, really close round. I think because of the first round, Samy Sana may be walking away here with a giant upset. What do you guys think?
I think it's going to be close, but you know what? If I had to edge one way, and again, folks, strictly unofficially, a 10-8 opening round, Samy Sana, I'd edge it to Samy Sana.
Is Yod get the last two, or did Samy? I don't think it's an edge. I might be,
No draws in one Super Series, folks. Let's see what happens. Who goes through?
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision. And advancing to the one featherweight kickboxing World Grand Prix semifinal, and one step closer to the $1 million grand prize.